Drivers Championship. Tejas Hirani will take part in the 4 races in I-Series in Sweden, and after which he'll proceed to the RX Lights World Series, where he'll tackle 7 European-based events. In the studio now to discuss the issue of Tejas Hirani landing that superlative contract with the Swedish company, I have in the studio Abdul Sidi, the director of Abdul Sidi Rally Academy, and also we have Shadrach Odinga Andenga to take us through this discussion about talent identification in matters rallying and also in football. Welcome to the studio, guys.
Thank you.
It's only 11 days into the year.
Yeah, it's
how has it been for you?
It's been good, and mixture, good and bad, but we look forward to a better year.
Mm-hmm. How has your year been so far?
What you call in French, comme ci, comme ça. Uh-huh. You know, just so. I'm still waiting for the president to fire Hassan Wario.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
You still have the beef with the cabinet secretary for sports?
Yeah. It's not that I hate the guy. I just think when if he goes home, it is for the betterment of sports in Kenya.
Mm. Yeah. But this fresh air now breathing into, breathing across the Kenyan rally fraternity, if we forget about the cabinet secretary and his ineffectiveness, as he wants to put it, Tejas Hirani, that's brilliant talent coming from the rally.
Actually, it made me laugh. I'll not comment on the political side of it. Motorsport, as much as we want to keep it clear of those politics, still we carry on. But it's been a brilliant year for Tejas Hirani. Hardly 18, he's turning 18 this year, been 17. And he's been doing so well since he was 13. And that's a very young age for a person to get into a car and perform as good as he has done. Don't forget, and I'm sure majority of the viewers and the people who follow motorsport and follow Tejas, he represented Kenya in swimming. And before he was a swimmer. Uh-huh. And he swam for Kenya in Zimbabwe. Uh-huh. And after that, he decided now, instead of staying in water, let me stay on land and do better things than on a four-wheel drive instead of using your limbs. So yes, to achieve and to sign for a world team like what he has done in Rallycross, his first event will be at the end of the month in Sweden, where he will tackle 4 events. Then he has to also do 4 more events in America.
Uh-huh.
For such a young guy, I think it is historic, because it's not only in Kenya, I think it's in the African continent, that you get a young guy like that performing so well. And don't forget, like I was just talking to my friend here, he started at 13 when he had no driving license. Yeah, lawfully it's illegal, but in rallying you're allowed, because there's certain places where if you have to cross onto the main road where it's not a closed circuit, then your navigator, who is a licensed driver, he takes over to take you to the main competitive stage.
Interesting, because at that age, and the fact that he has signed with a Swedish company, we all know that the Swedes and the Finns are some of the best rally drivers. Is it that they have seen something in this young man?
For you to be picked up a world-renowned team, and especially you're not talking of just Africa or Kenya, you must be a good person. Your talent must have been exposed. He has done so well. He did well in golf. He won events there, and he's gone on to perform very well in the rallycross events. And don't forget, these cars are so powerful.
Uh-huh.
The light is a 4x4 wheel driven car.
Yes.
It's a 2.3-liter engine, producing 330 bhp, and it's got a 6-speed sequential gearbox. And to handle such power, it's amazing. You know, in the World Rally Championship and even the Kenya Rally here, the cars that we allow, the bhp, the maximum bhp is 300. In the rallycross, it's 330 bhp, and it's such a powerful thing to handle for a young guy like Tejas. I really feel excited and happy that a Kenyan has got somebody who is representing at the highest level.
Interesting, Shadrach, because at that age, 17 years of age, and then already he has shown that kind of talent. We've seen in other sports that just identifying talent at that young age is a bit of a problem. How encouraging is Tejas Irani's performance?
I mean, it's so encouraging, but if I would analyze it, I see it as maybe a fluke. Because
it's a fluke. Rally Academy.
I mean, he has a Rally Academy, but for Hirani to get the contract abroad, I mean, it's not like the Rally Federation here did something that, you know, it's maybe whoever tried to take him abroad, whoever did whatever he did to Rob expose him. If we were talking about the Rally Federation, because in my belief that there are so many Hiranis, there are so many young kids or young talents who start at that age in Kenya, but still end up getting nowhere. Because we're starting at the federation level. If the federation was that organized, then we'd, right now we'd maybe have 7 Hiranis out there. Mm. So for me, it's a good gesture. In Swahili, we have a saying that we say, Samaki mkunja ngalimbichi. You know, the same, just when they're starting, you can nurture them, and it's so easy. You know, you can't teach an old dog new tricks.
He is raising a very crucial point here, that whose responsibility is it to scout for talent?
I agree with him. I share your sentiments. What he has done, and he's been very fortunate, his mentor is one of the best former rally drivers ever known in Kenya, Rob Collinge. Mm-hmm. And if you remember, if you were born that during that period, he introduced Range Rover, Kenya Jew, and he finished.
You can see the young man is talking there. I don't know if we have the sound from him, so that we listen to what he's trying to say. Let's just find out if we can be given that sound bite. But then, as we wait for that,
Like I said, Rob Collins has been the force behind his success.
But let's take a listen to what he's saying.
Best team in the world, with the greatest people in the world.
He says that he's in the hands of the greatest people in the rallying world.
Yeah, you must. Beside having a support like that, you must have the talent, okay? And with him, last year alone and up to now, he's already won 8 national championships. Not in only one event, one category. He's won in rallycross, motocross, as karting, raid rally. Mention any discipline of motorsport, he's been there. So he's got the talent. But there again, I wish it had come from the federation, as you say. We would have many, many Iranis. We need, Tejas was fortunate that Rob Collin was behind his support.
I saw you at Koth Birot tunnel finals yesterday, and I was baffled that Premier League players were taking part in that final, and here we are talking about talent identification. They are talking about talent identification. And here we have Abdul Sidi, who runs a rallying academy. Just from all that, you still insist that it has to be the federation?
It has to be the federation. It comes from the top. When we do a radio show with my friend Steven Mkanga, I normally tell him, in the house of Robin Toskin, and he has a son known as Andenga, if Andenga becomes a thief and is jailed, we'll blame Toskin because you're the father. So we have to blame the father. And who's the father? The person in charge. It starts from the sports minister. He has to keep the federations in check. When you talk about football, for example, if you allow me to drift a little bit from rally, we talk about football. Where's the technical director? He has to set up structures first. You know, it starts with the federation's technical director. He sets up structures. Once you set up these structures, then, you know, you make sure that clubs even have their own scouts. And then when you talk about tournaments like Koth Biro, I like the idea behind Koth Biro, but then I don't think that players playing at the nationwide level, what now we call Super League or the Premier League, should participate in those matches.
Yeah, because I saw the
conditions are way deplorable. Way deplorable. Koth Biro by itself, the name means the rain is coming in Luo. And, you know, in Swahili, we normally say that utamu anjele ni kutikisa zele. You know, like when you drink porridge and it's in a calabash, you you know, you kind of shake it, you know.
So they
love Kotbiro because it's muddy.
It's muddy.
But then it's dangerous when you have a player like a player who plays for Gor Mahia and the salary is and it's standing out, and the Gor Mahia is paying the player 100,000 and they are going to pre-season, they're not going to risk their player with injuries going to pre-season. Or think about a team like Bandari, you know, they are preparing for the Champions League. Would they allow their players to practice in such conditions? So I think maybe it has its advantages, but on the other side, I don't think players playing at the Super League or the Premier League level should be allowed to play in those conditions.
Abdul, we're talking about football there, where they depend on tournaments like Kotbiro and all such stuff to identify talent. But in rallying, how do you go about, how do you just stumble on such talent as Tejas Irani?
Totally different. What is discussed about football and rallying, one thing, it's always, it's a joke, it's a, you can take it either way. For you to be a rally driver, you must have rich parents. Mm-hmm. Understand?
Rich parents.
Yeah, rich parents. Okay. So rallying is very expensive.
Yeah.
Football, you just need a...
an open ground.
Yeah, open ground, short T-shirt, and you're there.
Yeah.
Rallying, first of all, even before you sit in a rally car, you will have spent about 400,000 shillings just to get your gear. Fireproof overalls, hands device, gloves, shoes, whatever. It is all got to be recommended. You can't just go to Biashara Street or and buy it. No, you can't. With the helmet is 50,000, the hands device is 70,000, 80,000 for the overalls. So it's very expensive. In my case, and when, because I have more experience of rallying, I, after 25 years, now I'm putting back, and I saw exactly what people needed to start rallying, because others were on the other side of the wall and thought rallying, okay, is for the elite. You know, it's for the Muindi or Mzungu and full stop, and for the rich. But now, since I introduced the academy in 2010, I've got 60 who are rallying in Kenya. Now, for
upcoming
me,
drivers
upcoming,
and rallying.
And if I give
60
you...
60 rich kids?
From rich families, maybe.
Hopefully. I give you a good example. Dennis Mwenda didn't know how to even open a rally car door. How didn't know what a pace note is, how the notes read. He came, he joined. Eventually, he started rallying. He's won the Formula 2. He's a champion. After that, he's gone up, higher up into the main class. Now, this last year, at the end of the year, he's the Division 3 champion. You understand? What I do is give the basics. The rest is for them to get into a rally car and do it. I do it, and I'm proud of it, because I started in 2010. I do it for free. I don't charge at all. I do it in Kenya, Uganda, Tanzania, and Rwanda. And I've trained so many across the continent. This is a unique thing. It's I'm the only person in Africa that who does it. Not only training navigators and drivers.
Maybe because you are rich, I don't know.
No, I'm blessed. Let me tell you, I'm blessed. I don't have to have... big wallet at the back, but I'm so much blessed. I feel great. Not only rally drivers, navigators, and all that. I have trained marshals. Yeah, I've trained timekeepers and all that. So for you who had been on the other side of the wall, you're now on this side of the wall. You're rubbing shoulders with the elite of pro sport.
Yes,
but like I said, football is easy. You just find a small ground. There you go.
A rally car.
It's very easy to buy a rally car at 15 million shillings. The Ford Fiesta is 25 million shillings. The Evo 10 is 15 million shillings. But to maintain that car every rally is the most expensive. Difficult. It's like having a girlfriend. You go to a restaurant, coffee, tea, here and buy, we go.
But
when you get married, now you look at the bills, you buy milk, sugar, rent, everything.
It becomes difficult. But then, Shedrack, that is really, it's very expensive. Football, like he says, and we all agree, it could be cheaper. But how come we are not developing talent? We are not identifying that talent and develop it?
Like I said, first of all, I start with the Minister of Sports. He's not putting federations in check. And then when it comes to the Federation of Football, the technical director who's there is not doing his job. And then because the technical director is supposed to, you know, like when you go abroad, I remember when I was in Germany, Hamburg 2010. In Germany, even lower club teams have their own scouts.
Yes.
They have their own scouts. I remember I attended a football session at a park in Hamburg, and Schalke had sent like five scouts, and that's an under 14 tournament. Five scouts from Schalke. Schalke offered, that's a Bundesliga team. Sure. You know, they are looking for talent. So, Kotbiros, the finals were played yesterday, 1000 Street One. But where were top clubs like Tusker, FC Leopards, Gor Mahia, Bandari? You know, because you're looking, I'm not looking for a player that is going to sign right now and play for the, you know, I'm looking for a 16-year-old, a 17-year-old, a 14, 15-year-old.
So saying that a tournament like Kotbiro maybe should scale down on the age bracket.
No, I'm not even talking about the age bracket. Yeah. What I'm talking, if maybe what the organizers of Kotbiro, I'll think about putting some limitations. Mm-hmm. If you're playing the Super League or the Premier League, this is not your place. Uh-huh. This is not your place. Don't practice here because the stakes are too high. Yeah. You know, a team like Tusker is able to pay a player 70,000-80,000 Kenya shillings. Mm. And maybe inclusive of training allowances, this guy will rake in 150,000 Kenya shillings in a month. That's a lot of money for someone who came from Kibra, Madare, Mukuru Kwa Njenga, Kwa Ruben, or Maringo, where I come from. That's a lot of money. And you have a club that's investing in that guy. And then when it comes to preseason, I'm coming with a broken leg because I was playing Kotbiro.
It does mean then that maybe they lack strategy, they lack focus, as opposed to what we see now in rallying?
Mm-hmm. That is one. We lack strategy. But that's the greatest thing. If you don't have strategy, then there's nowhere where you're going. Mm. You know, it's just what we call shagala bagala in Swahili. Mm. You're just moving in a zigzag direction. As long as you can end up anywhere, you're good. You know, that's the direction in Kenyan football. We just end up anywhere. We can talk, just like he's talking about Hirani, we can talk about Victor Mugubi Wanyama. Yeah. You know, for me it was a fluke. Yeah. Because why can't we talk about, just like Nigeria, how many professional players they can talk about?
Yeah.
Over 50 playing in those top leagues. We only have one. That's a fluke.
FA really helps. Now, to develop, tell me, Abdul, do we have other Hiranis? Have you seen from your undertakings at the CDA, Abdul CDA Rally Academy, just as we wind up?
Yes, the talent is there. There's so many who are coming up. And don't forget, Kenya is now, apart from Irani, we've got African champion here. Mm-hmm. We've got Jesse Chate, who comes from Kibosi in Kisumu. Mm-hmm. He's the ARC champion this year. He is also the Kenya national rally champion.
Sure.
So he's a young guy also. We look at Rai, Omkar Rai, Rajbi Rai, Tejvi Rai.
Mm. Upcoming drivers.
But like what he said, with football, where you limit, you need to restrict certain ages and professional qualifications to come and mingle around with the amateurs.
Yes.
And in the sport, especially in Kenya, we've got a very encouraging plan where we've got different groups. When if you want to start, and not necessarily that you must have a 25 million vehicle and stay with the top guys there, Carl Tundo and Ian Duncan, you start from the bottom, which is a two-wheel drive car, which for the spares you can go to Kirinyaga Road there and buy whatever you want.
That's interesting.
It's got the two-wheel drive, the classic car, the SPV. SPV is the locally manufactured vehicles. And then you've got the supercars, but you've got different classes. If you win your class, it's as good as having won the overall. So it's very encouraging.
Mm-hmm. Just in one sentence, Shadrack, because we are running out of time, what can football learn from rallying? As we wrap it up, yeah.
You talked about strategy.
Yeah.
Let me just wind up there.
Okay.
Football, we learn strategy.
We need strategy from Shadrack, Odinga, and Denga, that football must learn from rallying, all matters to do with strategy so that it can move forward. We've been talking about the development of Tejas Hirani, who has landed a contract in Sweden. I think it's a good move for the Kenyan youngster. I've been your presenter, Robin Toskin. Until next Monday, when we have another session of Sports Chat.